Oh, why hello, I didn't see you there. Today, we'll be talking about Physeter macrocephalus, but you might know him better as the sperm whale. This stately creature's exterior is configured around a spine that can reach 20 meters in length. Much like your spine, the spine of a sperm whale betokens its character, audacious and noble. Proportionally, the sperm whale has the largest flukes of any whale, 16 feet from tip to tip. The tail is his sole means of propulsion. Scroll-wise coiled forwards beneath the body and then rapidly sprung backwards, the tail gives that singular darting motion when furiously swimming. His side fins only serve to steer by. The spectacular sight of a sperm whale jackknifing to dive and thrusting the whole of his tail like two great wings out of the water usually indicates a deep dive. In no living thing are the lines of beauty more exquisitely defined than the crescentic borders of these flukes. His august hump, if I mistake it not, rises over one of the larger vertebrae and is, therefore, in some sort, the outer convex mold of it. From its relative position, then, I should call this high hump the organ of firmness or indomitableness in the sperm whale. The sperm whale spends 90% of her life in the deep, and as such, in each of her dives, she remains submerged for as many as 90 minutes, venturing to depths of 2,250 meters. Her myoglobin, which stores oxygen in muscle tissue, is much more abundant than in terrestrial animals. With each breath, the sperm whale renews 80% of the air in her thoracic cage, nearly eight times that of a human. When you dive, your oxygen comes 34% from your lungs and 13% from your muscles. When the sperm whale dives, she absorbs only 9% of her oxygen from the lungs and 41% from the muscles. The myoglobin makes long dives possible so that for an hour or more, 1,000 fathoms in the sea, the sperm whale carries a surplus stock of vitality in her. The sperm whale spends only 7% of her time sleeping, and she does so in a peculiar fashion. Positioning herself vertically with head just below the surface, the sperm whale enters a submarine slumber, engulfing both sides of the brain, usually between the hours of 6 p.m. and midnight. Can you imagine if your nose was offset on your face? You would look silly, just silly. Well, the sperm whale's blowhole is offset on the side of his head. This causes it to spout to the left at a 45 degree angle. And as of all ponderous beings, such as Plato, Darwin, Dante, and so on, there always goes up a certain semi-visible steam while in the act of thinking deep thoughts. The sperm whale boasts 36 to 52 identical teeth, lining its lower jaw, weighing up to 2.2 pounds apiece. These vary in length from 4 to 8 inches. Lively sketches of whales and whaling scenes, graven by the fishermen themselves, can be found in 18th century scrimshaw. The scrimshanders would then use pigment to highlight their handiwork. This majestic marine fauna, who, to all appearances, is so well armed to be a flesh eater, does not, in fact, chew his food at all. Instead, he swallows his food whole, in a gulp, and pulverizes it in the first of his four stomachs. The second stomach is larger and is where digestion takes place, and squid beaks accumulate, as many as 18,000 in a single leviathan. This is not so surprising given the sperm whale's labyrinth of intestine. While your intestine is 5 or 6 times the length of your body, the sperm whale's is 24 times the length of his, measuring up to 1,000 feet. Accumulated squid beaks spill over into hind gut and precipitate the formation of ambergris, a cholesterol derivative so highly fragrant and spicy that it is largely used in perfumery, in pastilles, precious candles, hair powders, and pomatum. The sperm whale's considerable head is sublime. Taking up roughly one-third of its length, the head contains a number of fascinating structures. The upper part, known as the case, may be regarded as the great Heidelberg ton of the sperm whale. As that of Heidelberg was always replenished with the most excellent of the wines in the Rhinish Valley, so the ton of the whale contains by far the most precious of all his oily vintages, namely the highly prized spermaceti in its absolutely pure, limpid, and odoriferous state. The sperm whale draws air through his right nostril and forces it through a pair of phonic lips, emitting a series of rhythmic cracking sounds at a very high sonic frequency so as to explore the waters around him. The sound travels through the spermaceti to the frontal sac, a knob-covered wall that serves as a superb acoustic mirror, and redirects forward through honeycomb-like junk tissues, which focus frequencies outwards. If their echolocation discloses the presence of one or more sizable squid directly underneath, then they dive vertically and go straight to their quarry. The giant squid is by no means an easy prey for the sperm whale. It has a well-developed nervous system, excellent eyes, and salivary glands that secrete a poison. We can surmise that the whale's attack depends on surprise. It tries to rush in and swallow the squid before the latter has time to resist. He does not always succeed, and when this is the case, the battle between these two giants with such different weapons must be on a scale beyond our power to conceive. Sperm whales also communicate with one another using lower frequencies known as codas. They can hear and locate one another at distances of over 3 nautical miles. When cruising through breeding grounds to court females, males emit yet lower and slower frequencies, much like the smooth baritone vocals of Barry White.
Baby, please don't do that.
The sperm whale's brain is the largest in the animal kingdom. Weighing in at 17 pounds, it is 5 times larger than my brain, or yours for that matter. Even though our brains are bigger for our body size, they aren't as convoluted as those of most cetaceans. The area of the human neocortical surface is about the size of a dinner napkin, but the common dolphin neocortical area is bigger than an unfolded newspaper or magazine. The sperm whales? Well, I haven't measured it, but I would hazard a guess that it is much, much larger, perhaps of genius proportions. But how? Genius in the sperm whale? Has the sperm whale ever written a book, spoken a speech? No, his great genius is declared in his doing nothing in particular to prove it. Keep in mind, kids, the sperm whale is still hunted today in countries like Japan, Iceland, and Norway, where it is stripped down for parts. Its spermaceti is used in golf balls and candy, its tongue in sushi, its blubber in ice cream, and of course, its penis is made into bow ties. Thanks for watching, and rest assured, no whales were harmed in the making of this film. Join us for our next installment. Is your neighbor an extraterrestrial?
Don't do that. Baby, please don't do that. What are you crying for? Is it because you're sad or mad or... Nothing's gonna go wrong. Sometimes we feel inside of us that everything we have is only here for today. But every now and then, two people get lucky.